advice to win, it would be bad. You'd have to kill somebody else to win. I don't think that's good advice.
You know, smart wins out most times.
Take no prisoners. Be aggressive. Have no friends. Be Courtney. That's victory.
What would be your weapon of choice in 100 games?
I want the trident, and I just want to like stab people. It's like a pitchfork, and I could just like, I feel like I could throw it really well, and oh, there's so many people that I just
wow.
They should just do what they do best, keep being themselves.
Do whatever it takes to get to the end.
And so it was decreed that each year, 8 middle schools shall offer up tributes of young men and women in 9th grade to be trained in the art of survival in the IB program. These students had no idea what would hit them. They entered bright-eyed, full of hope and strength. At first, it was all fun and games. And then all of a sudden, people began to drop.
Despite the lost tributes, many still survived and have lived to reflect on the IB class of 2016.
Okay, so can you describe this year's IB class?
We just talked about anal probes. Let's move on. This class was rough. It was great. I love this class and everyone in it. Oh, the camera, oh, it's great. It's a great class. I call this class the proctologist.
We've said so many things about you guys, mostly curse words.
Words cannot describe this year's IB class. That's about it.
My best moment of IB was when Platt said I got a total of 4 points on my IA. Not a four, 4 points.
This year's IB class is, I would say, driven, motivated, positive, very special group.
Like a lot of other IB classes, you know, intellectual, curious, ambitious, certainly.
Aggressively mediocre, but that doesn't seem to suit Tiki.
It's one of the best classes I've ever had.
This year's class? Well, they're my favorite. They're the best. They're my tortugas.
You're an unwritten story. Let's go with that. And we shall see what happens in May.
What do you believe were the most memorable moments from the class of 2016?
I just remember them as a wonderful, wonderful group. Cody was very entertaining and interesting and a challenge. He was a challenge, but he's sharp. He's a sharp guy.
Most memorable moments from, you know, just laughing and joking in class all the time. You know, I mean, it's hard to put a thumb on one moment.
There's a lack of memorability with this class. It's interesting.
Tony made me yell for the first time in years. Thanks, Tony.
I don't know, a lot of things with students that have left the class. I mean, Sharky jumping off of high places, that's probably been used before.
Probably getting kicked out of Mr. Johnson's class freshman year and being outside, like in the cold or rain, just sitting there with like the wind, like in your just all these, every single time I got kicked out, like the worst weather conditions, like, and I'm out there by myself, no chair. Thanks, Mr. Johnson.
One was when Lindsay Brenneman was gonna open her hard-boiled egg, only to find that her mother didn't hard-boil it, so that was exciting.
How to handle Dalton's weird eye staring patterns. Because normally I make people awkward, so attempts to overtly make me awkward, I wasn't entirely ready for. And that's ultimately what I'd say about senior class, is that I just wasn't quite ready for it. I loved my dead dog on my door for Christmas. That was pretty sweet.
I have to say that this is the group that was showed their big heart when I had my accident, the people that came to see me, and all the little things and help that I got. They were pretty awesome.
Garrett came in late because his vehicle broke down, and he had an emotional episode, but then it went bad at the end when he saw dog crap on his shoes.
I did better than Caroline Bro on a history test.
What do you believe were the most memorable moments from the class of 2016?
Well, before we go any further with this, I want to know, is this a formative or a summative? And my mother is emailing you right now, so I'm not sure that this is really a good time for me. So what's the latest that I could redo this?
Yeah, and I was absent when you turned in the questions, so I need some extra time, and I want to know if I can get some bonus points, too, if I answer them really good.
Can you sum up the past 4 years in a single word?
Dreadful.
Unnecessary.
Ooh.
Stressful.
Purgatory.
Facetious.
Why?
Nice. That was good.
Over the course of 4 years, students found themselves in increasingly stressful situations. Although the suffering seemed endless and unnecessary, students and teachers alike formed alliances to ease the agony that was the IB program and helped one another thrive.
What were your worst moments of IB?
The moment before every single IA was due, like the night before when you're up at like 2 a.m. in the morning and you're wondering why the heck you did this to yourself.
Pulling the all-nighters for assignments that only, you know, worth formative points.
The nights were, we were so fortunate to get the 5 hours of sleep. That was, I'm very thankful
five
for that.
Hours.
5 hours, yeah.
That was my average. Yeah.
Well, I mean, for some of us, that's bad. For some of us, that's bad.
The best part, maybe, about IB as a whole is the fact that we are all suffering and hating our lives together.
My best moments, I guess, were when we would get all those tests every single day of the week. Those were always welcoming. I'd love to do homework.
I love not having a weekend.
Would you do IB again?
No.
No.
No. No. No. No. Never. Never. I only stayed in because I couldn't get out. But I don't regret it, but I wouldn't do it.
No comment.
Absolutely not.
If you put your hand in the blender because you're curious, could you do it again afterwards? That's pretty much IB right there. I mean, you put your hand in the blender and you're not going to do it again because, you know, it sucks.
Yeah.
In the Hunger Games, whom would you sponsor?
So this would be somebody nice. No wonder I'm drawing a blank here.
Who would I sponsor? How much would I have to invest?
Polar bears. Polar bears deserve to live just as much, if not more, than most of the class of 2016.
I think it would be Jack Neal. He's a funnier version of myself. I might sponsor Priya, because I'm told that we have similar musical tastes and that we both quietly slink to the background when challenged. That's ultimately who makes it through, you know, in a Hunger Games type situation, and it's the one that you don't see coming.
I would sponsor Laura Lestarza. She needs sponsoring, a lot of sponsoring.
Maybe Joseph Jeter, because I want to see a black guy win. That would be the one. Yeah, he probably wouldn't show up for it, though. He'd probably scuff up his brand new shoes, so he wouldn't fight that hard. Maybe I don't want to sponsor him. You're out, Joseph.
Okay. What do you think are strengths and weaknesses?
A lot of good listeners, not at all entitled, positive, and you can decide which are positives and which are negatives.
I think you think out of the box. I think you're very creative. You're one of the most creative groups that I had. You can do, you know, artistically and in terms of writing and speaking and thinking, and you just are a very creative group.
The strengths, you know, the obvious is the intellectual strength, the creativity of your class, the closeness that just comes with 4 years of struggle together.
You have the ability to turn whatever I do into something negative. Way to complain all year long, no matter what I did. Here's a dollar. Whoa, we wanted $2. Thanks, Santiago.
Strengths and weaknesses. Strengths would be getting by with a minimum amount of work.
In terms of strengths and weaknesses, you're all beautiful snowflakes of disappointment. If you want strength and weakness, Sophia is the strength, Garrett is the weakness.
The strength is that everybody's really super smart. And the weaknesses is that sometimes we want a lot of things just handed to us.
Things happen, we move on, but generally speaking, I'll always look back at your class pretty fondly.
You guys are the most mentally fragile group of people I've ever seen in my life, and physically. Anytime there's a test, you guys are sick. Thanks, all of you.
Your class is very bipolar. You've got very good students, and then you've got very other students.
Who would be most likely to die first?
Mustafa, because I will kill him.
Julian Maldonado, he would be asleep.
Probably Michelle Nelson. No way she can run in those shoes. Yeah.
They compete to the death.
So who of our class would die first?
Who do I want to die first?
Who would die first?
Who would die first? And it's about population growth, overpopulation of the world, the fact that we're past 7.3 billion people right now, and we're consuming enough resources every 30 years to consume all the resources on the planet in the next 60. I would say then, I don't know. But probably Tony or Matt Camel.
In the Hunger Games, who would be most likely to die first?
You had a lot of weak people this year. Are we allowed pharmaceuticals while we play the Hunger Games, or do they have to all be themselves? The trail of tears that Azanta might leave would obviously give her away.
I don't want anyone to die.
In the Hunger Games, who would most likely be the victor in the end?
I don't know, but it would probably be one of you girls.
I'm gonna say Courtney, because she'd probably stab all of y'all. I'm pretty sure she'd sell you guys out and like step up on a like bed of dead bodies to reach whatever ring she has to reach.
I think it would probably be me. I think my survival skills are better than you guys. But maybe not, you guys are younger.
Dalton. In the Machiavellian prince quality of this, in terms of backstabbing and calculation and the achievement of a goal, it wouldn't be like people would be applauding once he won, but he would win.
Who do I want to be the last one to survive? I'm going to go with Devon Gardner.
The Devon Gardner?
No, he's the one that should live. He's the man. Yeah.
Somebody Tiki. Sneaky Tiki. So even though he's not the best, he knows how to work his way around to win. And he's a pretty nice guy, sometimes.
Lydia Yang. Stealthy.
What would be your weapon of choice in the Hunger Games?
My personality.
A thermonuclear device.
I think I'd die really fast. I don't think I'd have enough time to get a weapon.
My weapon of choice would be my water bottle, probably, because I've had it every single day since the beginning of high school.
Have you ever hit anyone with that water bottle?
No comment.
What are your thoughts on Tony Khalil?
No comment.
Tony Yasa? Tony Khalil? I think he's an Egyptian like fugitive. That's why he has so many name changes. I'm not even sure if this is the real one. I think they replaced him. I don't know who this is anymore.
I didn't meet him enough to really understand him as a human being.
Oh, he is adorable. But he's a good guy. Great, a good guy.
How many times did Tony come to class per week?
I don't remember. It was so much. I mean, he was always there.
It might have gotten to 3 in this final quarter.
He was here. He probably averaged about once a week. It's a pretty good average. You don't ask Costner. It'd be once a month.
After four long, tenuous years in the IB program, teachers and now victors offer advice for future tributes.
Do you have any advice for future classes?
Probably drop out.
Don't do it.
Drop out.
Drop out.
Don't join IB.
Drop out.
I advise that you guys invest in some type of medical insurance for whatever needs you have it.
Do you have any advice for our future?
Do more than you did in high school, and especially better than you did senior year if you were in my class.
Great. No, don't procrastinate. You're going to, but you're going to regret it.
Don't be crybabies.
However much hard work you put in, that's going to be the result. So if you try really, really hard on something, you're going to get a very good result.
Stay in touch with the thing that has driven you to pursue IB, not in the actual execution in the last 2 years of the IB.
Yeah, this class, I think they should look into an untapped art of holding signs, but I think there are a few that I could actually stand out there and spin it.
Remember, this is the time that you have right now, and enjoy every moment.
I would definitely agree with that. Have fun at college, take on new experiences, enjoy life, and appreciate what you have.
There's a lot of stuff we can't control. Our thinking makes things so.
The secret lies in sleep. It's all in sleep. If you get enough sleep, you will do fine.
When you go through it, like, you start to think, oh, if I'm not going to like a top 10 university at the end of this, or if I'm not like in the top 10 of my class, or if I'm not president of every club, like I'm not being the best me that I am. Like, I'm not the best, but just be yourself. Just have fun. Like, this is high school.
Don't focus completely on academics, because that's not all that matters. You know, looking back on high school, I really do regret not spending more time with my friends and family and having those social moments outside of IB.
And that's one that I would abide by. Thinking makes most things so. So, you know, keep track of your own head.
You need to dream big, and you need to know that you can achieve your dreams and go for it and do what it is that you really want to do.
Is there anything you'd like to say to the graduating class?
Well, you know, it's been a struggle for a lot of you. It's hard. You know, hopefully when you look back, you'll remember mostly good stuff. You know, we talk about it in class all the time. A lot of good stuff in life only comes through some inherent difficulty, so ultimately don't forget, you know, usually in life the juice is worth the squeeze.
You're the canary in the coal mine. I mean, we're going to be dead in 10 years as a civilization, so you were the warning track that we're heading there.
I'll miss everybody. I really will miss this group. I will.
I just want to give a shout out to Caroline. Well done. Let's pause for a few minutes, because I'm sure the rest of the crowd is going to be applauding for a few minutes. Okay.
All books end, so I'm happy this one's over.
We love you guys. We wish you the very, very best.
Yeah.
Here we are now, barely alive and breathing. We are stronger, braver, and smarter. We are the class of 2016. And we want to thank everyone who made our IB experience what it was.
So this is your last year. So, I don't know, like, do you have anything to say to our class or to the school in general with it being, you know, your final year?
Well, it's very sad. Being here at Creek has been very different than any place I've ever been in my career. And what I love about it, and what I love about your class, is the diversity of people's thought, their backgrounds, their religions, and how they try to put that information out, you know, things that they know, to share with others, and how, at least in your class, it seemed that people were very open to that, to listening to these different perspectives, and I have really, really, really loved that. I also really, really love how hard students have worked for me and you know, how they've become people who come to see me all the time. I think about them all the time, and I'm really going to miss them.
We're going to miss you two so much, Ms. Ward. I'm just, like, in a lot of our interviews, we asked the students what their favorite, who their favorite teachers were, and I'm 99.9% of them said you were one of the teachers that changed their high school career.
That's really sweet.
Because, I mean, a lot of, you all know, like, your class, we thought it was very hard, but it's also very, you prepared us for IB. You prepared us very well. And I know even in my English class, we still think about you every day, so.
I don't know what I'm going to do without you guys.
For Ms. Milford.
You always made learning really fun, to the point where I was almost in tears crying almost every day in class.
And your passion was just so contagious that it made such a boring subject more enjoyable.
And we will always remember your learning techniques of studying in the bathroom.
For Ms. Milford, you were my first chemistry teacher and my first introduction to chemistry at all, and I fell in love with it. Now I'm going to major in chemical engineering in college, so thank you, Ms. Milford.
For Ms. Wittenberg, going into Spanish, I had had a previous history of just always, it's always been my most difficult subject. It's always been really an arduous journey for me to get through Spanish. But going into your classroom, the way you facilitated conversations and really allowed us to learn more about the culture that is Spanish and so much, it's just means so much to me as a student. And to really find out new ways to learn things, and I had never experienced that before. So as a teacher, we really appreciate just how much time, how much effort you put in, and how you've always made us laugh, and you've always made us smile. And there's no way you can put a price on that. So all of your hard work and effort has put so much into the school, so much into the community, and we thank you so much for that.
For Ms. Wittenberg, thank you for making Spanish fun and making me laugh with all your really crazy stories and jokes.
For Dr. White, thank you so much for this past year of being our teacher. I honestly couldn't have hoped for a better teacher and a better year. I speak on behalf of second period as well as first and third, but second was your favorite. But we all really enjoyed you this year. We learned so much more than we could have hoped for, and I can honestly say that I feel really prepared for college and life beyond just because of all of the material that you taught us.
For Dr. White, thank you for using pool noodles as a prop, getting really excited about genetics and making every day a blast. I can honestly say I had a great time in biology. Thank you.
For Ms. Ward, I remember walking into your class the first day of school and being completely terrified, but really you were like a Paris Island Marine boot camp instructor. You broke us all down and then built us up back up better than we were before.
For Ms. Ward. All right, Ms. Ward, I had a fantastic time in your class. I enjoyed the cask of Amontillado. It was really touching in many ways. I also loved that stress ball you had for me. You squeezed every time I talked. I think that was a romantic gesture. I very much appreciated it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
On behalf of all of us, I just want to say thank you.
And with that, we end the year and we wave our farewells. Here's to the future. Here's to our teachers, administrators, parents, and students. Here's to the IB class of 2016.
I want the trident, and I just want to, like, stab people. It's like a pitchfork, and I could just, like, I feel like I could throw it really well, and, oh, there's so many people that I just...
Wow.
They should just do what they do best, keep being themselves.
Do whatever it takes to get to the end.
And so it was decreed that each year, 8 middle schools shall offer up tributes of young men and women in 9th grade to be trained in the art of survival in the IB program. These students had no idea what would hit them. They entered bright-eyed, full of hope and strength. At first, it was all fun and games. And then all of a sudden, people began to drop.
It's one of the best classes I've ever had.
This year's class? Well, they're my favorite. They're the best. They're my tortugas.
You're an unwritten story. Let's go with that. And we shall see what happens in May.
What do you believe were the most memorable moments from the class of 2016?
I just remember them as a wonderful, wonderful group. Cody was very entertaining and interesting and a challenge. He was a challenge, but he's sharp. He's a sharp guy.
Most memorable moments? From, you know, just laughing and joking in class all the time. It's hard to put a thumb on.
Despite the lost tributes, many still survived and have lived to reflect on the IB class of 2016.
Okay, so can you describe this year's IB class?
We just talked about anal probes. Let's move on. This class was rough. It was great. I love this class and everyone in it. The camera, it's great. It's a great class. I call this class the proctologist.
We've said so many things about you guys. Mostly curse words.
Words cannot describe this year's IB class. That's about it.
My best moment of IB was when Platt said I got a total of 4 points on my IA. Not a four, 4 points.
This year's IB class is, I would say, driven, motivated, positive, very special group.
Like a lot of other IB classes, you know, intellectual, curious, ambitious, certainly.
Aggressively mediocre, but that doesn't seem to suit Tiki.
Advice to win, it would be bad. You'd have to kill somebody else to win. I don't think that's good advice.
You know, smart wins out most times.
Take no prisoners. Be aggressive. Have no friends. Be Courtney. That's victory.
What would be your weapon of choice in 100 games?